they're just really there for each other, and I just think it's a true friendship.
I would probably describe it as genuine, pure, honest.
And ever since I've known them, they've always been friends, they're always together.
Two people that hold each other accountable. You can just tell by the way they look at each other that they're best friends, and they want to push each other to their fullest potential.
Very loyal, I would say. Just, we've been together through everything pretty much, and just, we always rely on each other.
Yeah, we've never gotten a fight. Like, we're just always there for each other.
Kylie and Gracie have grown up together since kindergarten. Their friendship was built on all the little things and the love of basketball.
We basically do everything.
We do everything together.
I drive her around.
I buy her hometown nutrition.
Yep. But we go to Target, Red Sun. We go to
Red Sun. Yeah, I'd say really just little things, like going to Target.
Yeah.
Going to.
And we're also just at basketball with each other. So we like spend the whole school day and then we're at basketball.
They both have loved basketball. They never played on the same basketball team in elementary school, but then, of course, in middle school, they were super stoked to be on the same team.
I know that I can always count on both Gracie and Kylie no matter what. They're two people that want to do the right thing for themselves, and they want to do the right thing for the team, whether that's on the court, in the community, in the classroom. I know that I can count on both of them to get the job done.
Really just me being a point guard and her being a post, it just goes hand in hand.
Pick and roll, buddy.
Pick and roll. We have it every time.
Her passes, I mean, we just got the connection. I mean, I'm like, just like, go. And they're like, okay.
I think they both bring a positive mindset.
No, just having her there with me throughout all my basketball experiences has been something that I will definitely cherish forever.
Because I enjoy playing with her and like all my other teammates.
Basketball isn't the only thing they share a common interest in. FFA runs in their family, and the girls have enjoyed it ever since middle school.
They're one of the few that get started in middle school, and they've been dedicated to it the whole time they were in middle school and high school.
They've grown up in the agriculture community, and their dads were both in FFA at Whiteland.
It teaches good leadership skills, and just all around, it's a pretty neat thing to be involved in.
During the fair, We just hang out, like, with our project. She shows pigs, I show cattle. I mean, we just kind of help each other, are there for each other, support each other through all of it. And, like, FFA, we just
do a bunch of projects together, yeah. Go to a national convention together. We always room together. So just having each other through all that is really fun.
My favorite memory of them has to be when they were in third grade, they started 4-H.
The fun for probably when we were kids was the first year of 4-H.
And at the end of the week, they have to sell their animals.
We were both really sad because she sold her pig, I sold my cow, and then my mom took us to get something to eat because we were so sad.
And they were bawling their eyes out, like bawling. So I took them out to get something to eat to try to calm them down. And
she was eating a cheeseburger and I was eating a pork kebab.
And they were walking down, eating, still crying. And I said, here's the deal. You don't have to sell your animal next year, but you have to never eat what you're eating right now.
So we're basically eating each other's animals.
And we were just bawling our eyes out.
Yeah.
And they looked at it and they're like, eh, like it's not worth it. And they were fine. So it just made me laugh and I'll always remember that.
The girls are each other's cheerleaders. And during the 2021 Johnson County Fair, they got to support and celebrate their big accomplishments together.
This summer, Kylie's always talked about being in the Queen Contest. And she did really well. She got on the court. She did a great job.
I would probably say when Gracie won Grand Champion Steer,
her winning on the court for Miss Johnson County.
Second loser.
I
was on the Queen's court, yes. And then she did win Grand Champion Steer. Yeah. So winning together was pretty amazing.
When she handed me my banner when I won, that was just like,
that was awesome,
what?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah,
we have some pretty amazing pictures that captured that moment,
yep.
too.
Yep.
So
Two girls that shared a love of basketball and love for the agricultural community became lifelong friends here at Whiteland Community High School.
Just watching them grow as, you know, the ladies that they have become, and watching their friendship blossom, and just the love and passion they have for each other, and they always have each other's backs.
They're always laughing. They have a really good time, and that makes me happy, and I think they'll be friends for a very long time.